This next question comes from one of the 1 minute design reviews titled Remove the Ferrites. I swear, it's not gonna be a Zach Peterson video unless I talk about ferrites. On PCBs that control motors and have high current density, is it necessary to divide ground for power and for the rest of the circuit? No, my biggest concern is that large currents and the rapid switching of the transistors generate ground bounce on the planes and interfere with the rest of the board. While it is true that fast switching can generate ground bounce, as long as you have a low inductive path to ground, you're going to minimize that ground bounce. Now, ground bounce is much more important in the case with high-speed digital because you typically have a lot of IOs running at once, and that generates a lot of ground bounce across all of those IOs. That's a topic for a different video. In this case, with motor control, you still have high edge rate switching. It may not be at the same time constant as in high-speed digital boards, but you do still have fast switching. And that is capable of inducing a return current in a nearby ground plane. And of course, that return current is going to follow that path where that current was generated. So I think it's very important to note that the most effective way to shield anything here is, of course, to use a very solid ground plane because it helps direct that return current where it needs to go. As soon as you start splitting up a ground plane, you then have to worry about where does that return current go? How does it dissipate its energy? Well, if it doesn't have anywhere to go, it just radiates. And that's where you get these EMI, EMC problems. So I think whenever you see those recommendations to start splitting ground in really any type of system, you're seeing those recommendations from people who have never had to go through EMC testing.